In this problem, we're going to look at an endothermic reaction that takes place in a plug flow reactor. It's second order, and we're given the rate constant. It's dependent on temperature. And we're feeding A, just pure A, into the reactor, 250 degrees C. And we're given an inlet concentration. Reactor diameter is 8 centimeters. And this matters because the heat transfer area to volume depends on the diameter. And we're given a heat transfer coefficient. So in order to make this reaction take place, we have a steam jacket, high pressure steam, that heats the fluid by heat transfer through the walls. And the question is, the temperature immediately downstream from the inlet, is it higher or lower than the feed temperature? Or the alternate way of looking at this is, are we adding more heat than we're needing to carry out the reaction? In other words, if we carried out the endothermic reaction adiabatically, the temperature would decrease. So are we adding enough heat for the heat reaction? Are we adding more so the temperature increases? Are we adding less so the temperature decreases? So what we want to do is write down the energy balance for this system. And it's always good to draw a diagram first. So I've drawn a diagram where schematically represented the jacket, where the blue corresponds to the steam that's coming in. So we're at constant temperatures, it condenses, flows around the outside of the tube and exits at the same temperature. So the energy balance, we're going to write this in terms of mass flow rate. So density times a volumetric flow rate would be a mass flow rate. Heat capacity per mass, the change in temperature with respect to cumulative volume. Volume equals zero here. Volume in the reactor is a total volume. All we're interested in is right at the inlet, however. Temperature changes for two reasons. We have a heat reaction times a rate of reaction. And we're using R sub A, which is minus KCA squared. So that's the reaction term. And then we have a heat transfer term that looks like this. So the temperature of heating minus the reactor temperature. And D is the diameter. So U is the heat transfer coefficient, which we're given. And D is the reactor diameter. And 4 over D comes from the ratio of the surface area for heat transfer divided by the reactor volume. Our question is this derivative positive or negative? In other words, is the temperature increasing? Evaluate it right at the inlet. So to do that, let's substitute some numbers in. So let's just look at the first term, heat reaction. This is positive, R sub A is negative. And so overall, this term is going to cause the temperature decrease, as we would expect for endothermic reaction. Notice that I have to make sure that I'm using Kelvin here. So I've added 273 to the feed temperature. And then I put in the units to make sure things are consistent. And then we want to look at the second term. And so again, I put the units in. Notice that I used centigrade here because we're looking at a temperature difference. So a 50 degree centigrade temperature difference is the same as a 50 degree Kelvin temperature difference. And of course, we want the units to be consistent. And so now all I have to do is multiply out these terms to determine whether this derivative is positive or negative. So we can see the second term has greater amplitude. So this is positive, which tells us the derivative with respect to volume is greater than zero. And so as we enter the reactor, the temperature increases. Namely, we're providing enough heat transfer to overcome the heat reaction, and the temperature increases, which of course will increase then the rate of reaction.